Hey Lego fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a Lego land or town set from 1980. This one came with 91 pieces and it's called the Snorkel Pumper. This is one of those sets that I really wanted as a kid but never got. Obviously, you've got an articulated system here with a nice long rotating turntable with the arm that will go way up. See how far up we can get that to go completely out of frame. Look at that. You can take it all the way up there. Got a nice little seat there where you put one firefighter. You've got a monitor up here where you spray the water out. Don't really have any place to hook the water up or any hoses or anything, but you kind of have to imagine that or use parts from another set. This is pretty nice the way that this is set up with the multiple articulation going on there, and it's got a little spot where it will come to a nice rest when you're not using it. These parts are a little bit old, so they're actually sticking a little bit, unfortunately. Sometimes when I pull this up, yeah, there you go. You can see it's trying to pull this up, and it's trying to pull those apart in there. That was one thing that was a little bit off about these hinges. Even when they were new, I remember that sometimes I have to grab this very carefully to keep it from pulling apart the parts that I didn't want to come apart. This right here is just something that is just going to happen from time to time. The small little wheels and tires, front and back, all the same all the way around. Little tail lights on there and headlights on the front of the thing. Got the little stands which you can actually move up and down. That's a very nice little design. It's so simple. Just basically, I mean, it's really just that one piece that's doing most of the work there, that kind of flashlight or gun or scanner kind of thing, but that's so elegant, and it allows you to, if you want, you could put both of those down. There's one on either side, and then just detach this and leave it. Just take the tractor section and drive off with it if you want to leave this thing behind. Not something you would normally do in the case of a fire, but it would stabilize it just in normal use. No top to the cab section. That's interesting. Allows you to easily access the seat to put the driver in there, but it would have been nice if they had included a roof for this. That poor sticker is really worn out, but you do see that you've got the opening door on the side. That is a sticker, interestingly. That's not a piece that you'll see very frequently, with the original sticker on there. A little bit worn down, as is this windscreen, but still get the general idea. Now that sticker is in much better shape. It's just a little bit crooked, but that's okay. You do have a couple of minifig accessories here. You've got the axe over on this side, and you've got the axe over on this side. You can also take off this monitor if you want to use that separately, but that's pretty much all that's going on with this original, you know, proper, correct, instruction-based build of the vehicle. Minifigs, simply put, the one on the left is correct, and the one on the right is 1 year too new. This one actually began to be distributed in 1981, or sets marked 1981, and it was used well into the 1990s. That is a very popular fire suit there, but this is the correct one, and you can see it actually has a sticker. Yes, a sticker. And the instruction sheet for this set even shows, and the box art even shows, that it's got a sticker on there. That one's unfortunately a little bit askew, but that's just really interesting stuff. So you just basically see two different generations. The first generation minifig version, full articulated minifig version of Fireman here, and then the second version, which lasted quite a long time, and you've got the black fireman's helmets and no prints on the back. To be clear, this set should have had two of this guy and none of this guy, because he didn't exist yet. I mentioned the instruction sheet, and here's the front of it, so you can see what the box art looked like, and you can also see a little bit of alternate build action here with a short version of a fire truck with a narrow hood on it. Just a very, very different build, and you can see it's actually set up to hold both firefighters seated. And then this is an alternate build of the trailer section, which interestingly enough, these guys are actually pulling along by hand. That's kind of weird, but I do like the kind of scissor lift section that they've got here by using both of the hinges just stacked on top of each other. That's a technique that I liked to use as a kid. And then on the back, you've got another bit of alternate build. just showing you a slightly different thing you can do for a little bit more of a fire car. And then there's another, it looks like a truck in the background. It's really unfortunate that they didn't keep that in focus or didn't show you that. Maybe on the box they do show you that, but it looks like they've managed to make an entirely separate truck. I think they may have used two sets though, so that might be the issue. You can also see yet another, what looks like parts from another set back here, but it's just a little bit of a mystery there. But definitely the car is a pretty nice build, and then you get a little bit of a preview of some stuff that was going on in Legoland in 1980. Well, minifig issues aside, this was a nice trip down memory lane. Even though I never actually had the set before, I sure looked at the picture a lot and wished that I had it and imagined that I had it. And I'm really happy to have been able to finally get it as an adult and to have been able to share it with all of you. If you would like, feel free to leave a comment and say what you think about this set. I'm going to move on, build some more stuff, bring you more reviews of old sets and new sets, and work on my custom stuff too. Follow the blog at JANGBRiCKS.com for all of the latest updates, including things that will never end up being shown on YouTube. And I'll talk to you again soon.